Is tonight a bigger game for the Chiefs or the Bills?
It's a great question. If I'm forced to answer that, because it's a big game for both, I'll say the Chiefs, whose defense has made them look vulnerable this year, but it didn't matter because Mahomes could overcome it until the last time we saw them, and then all of a sudden it was, nope, that's catching up to them. I think the Chiefs have to reestablish, especially actually on the defensive end, that they know 2 years ago they were a little underrated that way, but they really weren't quite good enough, although I felt, if not for a pre-snap penalty, that gave the Patriots new life in the AFC Championship game, they still would have probably won the Super Bowl. But then they actually did win the Super Bowl with a top third or so defense. The defense has looked like it's regressed. They're going to have to put out a better effort. And Mahomes is also going to have to show in a tough game he can work his magic. I think more is on line for the Chiefs, who no matter what happens, you always just believe are the best. Not if they lose, especially badly, this game.
I think you need to make up your mind. Do you believe in Patrick Mahomes or don't? Because you rave about how great he is and how he's the best on the planet and how there's really no need to panic. So if they lose this game, the reigning defending Super Bowl champions is going to be 4-2 instead of 4-1. Oh, my God, stop the presses. I mean, we have to stop it right now. I mean, what's going to happen to the Kansas City Chiefs if that happened? Excuse me. This game means virtually nothing to the Kansas City Chiefs. They're going to be fine. Even if they lose this game, they'll get their stuff in order with Eric Bieniemy, with Aaron, Andy Reid, with Tyreek Hill, with Travis Kelce, with all of these boys. The issue is the Buffalo Bills. Excuse me, you ain't been around primetime. We ain't accustomed to seeing the Bills in primetime. We're looking at this kid, Josh Allen. Let's look at his numbers here. Completed 69.3% of his passes, 1,589 yards, 14 touchdowns, just 3 interceptions, and a QBR of 86.8. Those are similar to the numbers Patrick Mahomes was putting up with his MVP season through those first 6 games in 2018. So when you look at Josh Allen, has he really, really arrived? Or is it all just, are we just blowing smoke here? Mm-hmm. When you look at Stephon Diggs, averaging over 101 yards a game. Excuse me, Minnesota, how's life without him now? Stephon Diggs is up in there. Okay, this brother's on center stage. Let's see what you've got. So when I look at the Buffalo Bills, Tre'Davious White was out with the shoulder injury. Now he's expected to come back in all likelihood tonight. I haven't guaranteed it, but they're anticipating he will come back. So we're going to find out what the Bills are going to do defensively because they've been struggling and they're perceived as being a different team when he's on there, on the field. I'm just looking at Buffalo right now, especially with New England struggling the way that they are, knowing that you have an opportunity to go up 2 games on them in a division that they have owned for the better part of the last 2 decades, and you are on a nationally televised stage against the reigning defending Super Bowl champions, widely considered to have the best quarterback on the planet. And, oh, by the way, you can still get up on the New England Patriots and provide yourself a cushion knowing you got 2 games this season coming up against New England. I would say Buffalo definitely has the expectations placed on their shoulders. I'm looking to see what they do.
This is 100% about the Buffalo Bills. Stephen A. is exactly right. If the Kansas City Chiefs go 4-2, we'll say, you know what? Andy Reid will get it together. Patrick Mahomes will get it together. Tyrann Mathieu will get it together defensively. And honestly, I disagree with you, Max, about this defense of the Kansas City Chiefs. They'd actually played pretty well this season. They kept them in the game against the Chargers when the Chargers were playing great defense against Patrick Mahomes. They shut down the Baltimore Ravens and Lamar Jackson. You go back to the week against the New England Patriots, even though there was no Cam Newton, New England couldn't move the football. And so I think the defense played well until last week against the Las Vegas Raiders. So I don't necessarily know that there's any questions in that building. Can this team make a Super Bowl run? But let's look at the Buffalo Bills. You beat the Las Vegas Raiders. You beat the Los Angeles Rams. You get your opportunity in primetime against the Tennessee Titans, and you're blown out of the building. This is a team, the Tennessee Titans, they couldn't even practice. 3 practices in 16 days. You're playing on a Tuesday, and they show up and they blow you out of the stadium. Now you get another week against another playoff contender, against Patrick Mahomes, against the Kansas City Chiefs, Josh Allen trying to ascend to be an MVP, not only candidate, but winner. And here's your chance. Yeah, everybody's watching. You're playing the defending champs. You get an opportunity to show you belong. You got to go out and do it tonight.
The Raiders put up a 40-piece on the Chiefs defense, a 40-piece. the Bills have one loss on the season. I know Miami's at 500, but the threat in the division is the Patriots, who are sitting at 2-3. You know, like, the Chiefs kind of last year when they hit a little bit of a rough patch, that was without Mahomes. They looked a little ordinary without Mahomes. This is with Mahomes. The Chiefs don't, of course, long term, you like the Chiefs. But right now, Chiefs don't want to lose back-to-back games, especially if they give up a lot of points, especially to another AFC title contender. I respect what you guys are saying because I think it's actually a tough call, but I would say there's more on the line for the Chiefs. Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.